it is a psychophysical force, and it is to be dealt in the same way in which we deal with the electromagnetic force. So it is possible. The techniques differ. For example, we have to use meditation, auto-suggestion. We have to use many other techniques of yoga, etc. Techniques may differ, but ultimately we have to bring about this change in human body, in human brain, in human biochemistry, in human biophysics, and through that only we can come to the betterment of a higher soul or spirituality. So I hope that all these things will be done. A few issues which were taken in our this conference, I want to draw attention, because here are people from judiciary. Four papers by research scholars were read on Santhara, which is not a custom, which is not a tradition, which is not at all a kind of what is called a ritual. It is a pure spiritual type of practice which has a strong spiritual base. It is under debate now in the country. The four research papers that have been given here, they have shown that in all law, in all legal aspects, Santhara is a purely spiritual practice. It is not a suicide, it is not a tradition, and so the country and the judiciary has to take into account the scientific aspect of this thing. Another thing which was drawn attention by Dr. Mahendra Patel, this abortion. Abortion is valid under certain conditions by law. It has been established in science and philosophy, as he has given the various evidence, that abortion in any form cannot be considered as less than a human murder. And therefore, the law or the judiciary has to reconsider that how such murder can be allowed legally. And we know that today, as the figures given by the Dr. Patel, that so many illegal abortions are taking place. Law cannot prevent them. And in this way, not only something which is illegal is done, but something which is inhuman is done. So society, legislation, and everyone has to think whether such laws should be enacted or there should be strict restriction on this abortion and other activities. And one more thing that is given about education is, let us again debate over the point that when education should start. Nowadays, there is some, I don't know whether there is some limit to the age or admission in the school. But as expressed here by the scientists as well as the spiritual sadhaks and scholars, that education should begin from the fetus life, from the embryonic life. If this thing is taken into consideration, let educationists, psychologists, scientists, biologists, neuroscientists, and spiritual people sit together to form such a course. It may be only voluntary. Let voluntary course be served to the pregnant mothers so that the outcome or the output or the born child will be a better human being in all senses. So let us think over all these things. I am very much thankful to all of them. There is a long list before me who have contributed in such a way that without their contribution, this kind of successful conference would not have been possible. I can't take the name of all of them, but at least I shall take the name of my colleagues. My colleague, Muni Ajit Kumarji, Muni Amrit Kumarji, Dr. Muni Amrit Kumarji, Dr. Muni Abhijit Kumarji, Muni Jagrit Kumarji, and Muni Sid Kumarji, they have given me this helping hand. I am now running 79. And without the helping hand of my colleagues, I could not have dreamed even of such conference. So my all thanks to my all colleagues. And Dr. Chaitanya Pragyaji and Charitra Pragyaji from our JVBI Institute, they have taken all the pains to make this conference a grand success. And all many people whose name it is very difficult for me to take, if I can take a few names, K.P. Mishra, Bina Punjabi, Sumermal Surana, S.K. Jain, Pooja Bhatia, Yasha Srisrimal, Komal Srisrimal, Narendra Bhandari, Kachara Saab, Sancheti Saab, Dr. Sancheti, Professor Vinay Jain, and Bipin Doshi, Vallabhji Bhansali, Manish Manot, Khalilal Tated, and all the Jain Samaj who have come here, Acharya Nandi Goswuriji, he spent all the 3 days here. So I think that all of them have contributed enormously in making this this conference a success. I hope that in future, this is first conference organized by BMIRC, and later on maybe we will organize at least biennial such conferences. I hope that we will do something better. All the suggestions, all the advice which has been given by so many people, we shall take into account and make our conference more and more suitable for both the speakers and audience. Now we come last to Basant Rajji Bhandari, our chancellor. He was the person who, in the first time when he was given this idea, he wrote to Acharya Sri Mahashramanji, who is the Anushasta. He is the chief disciplinarian of the university. And he gave him this idea that let such conference take place outside the university campus in Bombay, and it was organized here in IIT. And Acharya Sri Mahashramanji, above all, has his spiritual blessings, not only spiritual blessings, but his inspiration, his blessings in the words, in his words and his mental ideas that we have received all throughout the preparation, that was the main backbone of this organization of this conference. So I hope that our Guru Acharya Mahasraman will give his consent for the next this conference, international conference, if possible at Kolkata in 2017 during his Chaturmas there, and we shall see that in direct presence of Acharya Sri Mahasramanji, such conference will take again a more advanced step in this direction, and in this way we shall go further and further. So thank you very much, all of you. And I now, because now our it is our time, you know, all of you, we can't take food after sunset, and it is already the time. So I will have to leave. The function will continue. There is some people who are to be felicitated, and Basant Rajji Bhandari and Bipin G. Doshi, they will also speak. So I take that. Thank you.
Thank you.
There will be a felicitation ceremony. All the distinguished guests are here, and I will request Mr. Surana to please bring the people and bring the felicitation certificates. Dr. Peena Punjabi may kindly come and receive the prize. Mr. Ranjan K. Panda is the professor in IIT. Professor Anil Mudalkar. Dr. Subhadra Joshi. Pooja Bhatia, she is here. Yes, Srisrimal, Komal Srisrimal, all are here. They have worked till 4 early in the morning. Yogita Jain, Sarika Jain, Vishakha Jain. Surya Jain. Chinmay Shah. Tarun Jain. Anubhav Foundation team. Young United Volatile Activist, which is Volatile Activist, please. Kamlesh Jain, Praveen Dhariwal, Navtarmal Ganna, okay. These were the black cats of the conference. May I now request Navtarmal Ganna. Okay. Okay, okay. May I request Kamlesh Jain. The man who was responsible keeping the accounts and funding. Praveen Dhariwal. Navratanmal Ganna. Mr. V.C. Kothari. Mr. Abhishek Surana. Shri Sunil Gallera. Shri L.C. Singhi. Shri Mahendra Dakakia.
Ganga ko jal le, Ardh Purnima ko dina, isi prakar, I dedicate this to all the volunteers who have worked for this conference.
Abhishek Surana. Sunil Gallera. L.C. Singhi, first. Mahender Dakakia. Deepak Dagalia. Mrs. Raksha Shah. Oh, 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 oh. Don't go with the prayer. Aap mat jaiyega saath mein. Raksha Shah, Siddharth Kashyap, Arun Mehta, if there is a Sri Mahatraji Munot, if he is here, Sri Manish Monot is not here. Baisi. Aye, please, please, time is value. Is there anything else? Okay.
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि जैनिज्म बड़ा यूनिक है कि मैंने जितनी गलती की है जिसकी घंटी बजाई है मैं सबको क्षमा याचना की रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ. मिच्छामि दोकणम. आज सुबह और मैं आप लोगों से भी क्षमा चाहता हूँ क्योंकि कल मैंने कहा था मैं सूरत जा रहा हूँ और आप लोगों को कहा था पर मैं सूरत जा नहीं सका कोई कारणवश और आपके बीच रहा इसकी मुझे खुशी है. एक चीज़ मैं कहना चाहता हूँ कि आज सुबह एक डिस्कशन हुआ था कि बहुतों ने इंट्रोड्यूस किया आई एम नॉट ए जैन बट आई फॉलो दिस. मेरी समझ में ये है कि जैनिज्म के जो तीन प्रिंसिपल हैं सम्यक ज्ञान सम्यक दर्शन और सम्यक चारित्र. जैन पैदा होने से जैन नहीं होता है. जैन वही होगा जो इनको फॉलो करता है और नॉन जैन यदि इनको फॉलो करता है तो वो जैन है. तो ये एक दृष्टिकोण के मैं जैन पैदा कोख से होना जैन इज नॉट ए जैन. यू हैव टू फॉलो जैनिज्म. और कोख से पैदा जैन नहीं होने से यू कैन स्टिल बिकम ए जैन इफ यू फॉलो द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ जैनिज्म. इट्स नॉट ए रिलीजन इट्स ए वे ऑफ लाइफ. जो आप फॉलो करें तो इट्स ए वे ऑफ लाइफ. दूसरी चीज मैं ये कहना चाहूंगा कि एथिक्स इन बिजनेस इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड वी आर एज जैन्स समटाइम्स लैक. साइंस एंड स्पिरिचुअलिटी का एक बहुत अच्छा प्रैक्टिकल एग्जाम्पल मुझे स्वामी नारायण के स्वामी आत्मस्वरूप स्वामी ने दिया था जिन्होंने दुनिया में तीन बड़े भवन बनाए हैं अहमदाबाद लंदन और दिल्ली में अक्षरधाम. वो IIT बॉम्बे के सिविल इंजीनियर हैं 1970 के और जिन्होंने ये सब बनाए. उन्होंने कहा कि एक दफ़े अमेरिका में मुझे एक फैक्ट्री में ले गए कि हम आपको साइंस और टेक्नोलॉजी दिखाना चाहते हैं अमेरिका कितना उन्नत हो गया है. एंड ही सेज टू माय डिसमे दे टुक मी टू ए मीट फैक्ट्री. एज ए गेस्ट मैं कुछ कह नहीं सका. मैं उनके साथ चलता गया. उन्होंने कहा कि देखिए ये यहाँ पे आता है ये होता है इससे सब पार्ट्स अलग होते हैं ब्लड अलग होता है ये अलग होता है ये अलग होता है एंड प्रोडक्ट हो गई है. तो स्वामी जी ने एक सवाल किया व्हाट नेक्स्ट इसके बाद क्या होता है. इसके बाद कुछ नहीं होता है बाजार में चला जाता है. उन्होंने कहा जो धर्म है इंडिया में स्पिरिचुअलिटी है उसमें इसको वापस जोड़ दिया जाता है. जो आदमी टूट जाता है उसको धर्म वापस सही जगह पे ले आता है. तो द स्पिरिचुअलिटी इज वन विच ब्रिंग्स द ब्रोकन हार्ट्स टू द सेल्फ हार्ट. ये उन्होंने उनको संदेश दिया था. उन्होंने पूछा और क्या है तो उनका हमारे यहाँ कुछ नहीं. उनका हमारे यहाँ इसको जो टूट जाएगा टुकड़े टुकड़े हो जाएगा उसको वापस जोड़ देता है. ये धर्म है हमारा. और जैनिज्म भी जितने आपने सुने हैं उसमें यही योग देता है. जस्टिस जसराज जी ने कहा था वो भाई बिल्कुल सही कहा था. मैंने सबको यही बता दिया था कि ये 8 घंटे 10 मिनट का था. अब क्या होगा अब होगा एक्सपर्ट मीटिंग. एक ही सब्जेक्ट के एक्सपर्ट मिलेंगे और वो उस विषय पे 2-3 दिन विचार विमर्श करके निष्कर्ष निकालेंगे. ये सेकंड स्टेज होगा. तीसरा मैं ये कहना चाहूँगा मैंने आज कहा है कि आप लोगों ने जो नॉलेज दिया है उसको हम कंपेंडियम करके उसका सब करके और हम उसको पब्लिश करने की कोशिश करेंगे. मुनिश्री ने ऑलरेडी कह दिया है कि इसका फॉलोअप होगा. और कॉन्फ्रेंसेज होगी पर जो होगी एक तो ब्रॉड लेवल कॉन्फ्रेंस होगी पर बाकी एक्सपर्ट मीटिंग होगी जो एक ही सब्जेक्ट को डील करेगी. और 3 दिन तक 2 दिन तक जो भी समय मिलेगा वो वही सब्जेक्ट डील करेगी. जीवन विज्ञान या जो भी अपॉर्चुनिटी होगी उस पर अभी बहुत सा हुआ था. मैं सोचता हूँ कि आज की दुनिया में हमने बहुत सुने हैं ब्रिगेड आईसिस एंड कितनी ब्रिगेड हो गई है, बट व्हाट वी नीड इज ए पीस ब्रिगेड, अहिंसा पे जो ब्रिगेड होगी, और जैनिज्म इस पे बहुत कुछ कंट्रीब्यूट कर सकता है बेस्ड ऑन अहिंसा. हिंसा की बहुत ब्रिगेड हो गई है, चाहे जैश मोहम्मद कितने ही एलिटिक टेलिटिक बहुत नाम हो गए हैं, पर अहिंसा की पीस की ब्रिगेड होना बहुत ज़रूरी है. मैं टाइम ज़्यादा नहीं लूँगा क्योंकि समय हो गया है. एक हमारे मित्र जो बाहर से आए रॉल्फ प्रोफेसर भट्ट, भट्ट साहब तो यही हैं मेरे पास ही हैं, एक चीज़ और कहना चाहूँगा कि आईआईटी जैसा यहाँ विषय दिया है, हम लोग सब्जेक्ट टू सर्टन कंडीशंस बिकॉज बीइंग ए डीम्ड यूनिवर्सिटी वी हैव सम कंपल्शंस एज यू नो. तो हम चाहेंगे कि सब्जेक्ट टू आईआईटीसी एग्रीइंग एंड सब्जेक्ट टू इफ्स एंड बट्स जितने भी हमें पार करने हैं, वी मे कंसिडर सेटिंग अप ए चेयर इन आईआईटी फॉर फर्दर रिसर्च ऑन जैनिज्म. पर मैंने कह दिया है इट इज लॉट ऑफ बट्स बिकॉज वी हैव टू फॉलो लॉट ऑफ रेगुलेशंस ऑफ द यूजीसी एटसेट्रा उसके पर. नाउ आई विल रिक्वेस्ट प्रोफेसर भट्ट टू से समथिंग.
Mr. Chairman and Munis, dignitaries on the dais, learned scholars, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me immense pleasure to say that this particular conference has been, by any standard, a good success. Those who have found some limitations, yes, of course it is there, but then their expectation was quite high, I would say, in a conference when simultaneous sessions are going on, you can't attend every seminar, every paper. Obviously, people are unhappy. I can understand that, but it is inevitable, especially when so many papers have to be read. And in 3 days, we have been going from 9:30 to 8:30, and this is never done in a conference, but we are so enthusiastic that all of us are sitting through papers and still want to participate, want to say things and listen to others, and if allowed, well, we would have continued till 12 midnight. I am sure there are several limitations because the arrangements we could not make because the expected number was different and the actual turnout was double the number. So you can imagine in front, you know, food, shelter, almost everything was a problem at a certain level. But then I know you are, majority of them are Jains, and you can understand the problems of others very well. So we are going with that kind of faith that this, we will be forgiven for our mistakes, whatever they are, and appreciate whatever we could achieve. I want to say one or two things about the research projects, if anybody is going to seriously pursue. One point I want to make is this, that is, you had 24 Tirthankaras. Have you wondered why we needed 24 Tirthankaras? It's an age-old philosophy, almost parallel to Vedas, and 24 times the philosophy has been revised. Tirthankaras are not small philosophers. They are reformers. They have brought so much change in Jaina philosophy. But then, after Vardhaman Mahavira, you didn't have another Tirthankara of the same stature. Why? And what are we doing today? We are almost repeating, and we are not able to progress keep ourselves at pace with the developments of science and technology. And why is it so? This question needs to be asked. And if you know different branches of Jainism, metaphysics, epistemology, ethics, for example, all the three are beautifully interconnected. And also, in epistemology, epistemology of ordinary person, epistemology for experts, jinns, and the knowledge that they gain or knowledge that we gain through empirical method are quite different. And why science got separated from church in the West, and why is it that the same thing didn't happen in India? Indian philosophy, Indian religion are intermixed. There are several people who mistake Indian religion to be Indian philosophy, and they condemn both. And in fact, Indian philosophy is so great, so rigorous, and several schools of thought have been there in India, and you need not have to turn to West to find any ism or any philosophy that is in the world. We have everything. But what has happened is, we, because of maybe foreign invasion or some other consideration, I don't know exactly what the historical reasons are, the development stopped. Only the Nyaya school was very active up to 14th century. All other schools of philosophy in India, all the thing that we have been doing is to sustain. Earlier, oral tradition was there, now we write down. And even now, several Sanskrit works have not been translated. Same must be true of Pali texts and so on. So there isn't enough concerted effort to relate to our life, whatever tradition we had. I guess we need to really look at them. And one thing that inevitably will happen is, if you look at our tradition, if you want to link our modern technology and life today, science and technology, you need to modify your theory as well as your practice, perhaps. And therefore, let us go with our own, look at our own philosophy with an open mind. If need be, we will improvise on certain things, and if need be, we logically extend the concepts and try to do good science, good philosophy. Thank you very much.
In appreciation of the help provided by IIT, may I present this moment to you. Gentlemen, there will be a vote of thanks.
I think we are all entering the last moment of Thanksgiving. First of all, let's cheer off Muni Mahendra Modi ji, Bansraj ji Bhandari, Shamni Chaitranya Pragna, and the great person over here, Professor Mishra, whose under leadership we could do the best. And at the end, I'll stop with a small 1 minute story. There was a fire in the jungle. Everybody were trying to extinguish that fire. There was an elephant and there was a sparrow. Sparrow tried, and elephant says, "Sparrow, what you are doing? Your one drop will not make any difference. But friends, if drops of all of you can get collected, that drop may be bigger than the other drop. So we thank you very much for all of you to be here. Thank you very much."
Conference will end with national anthem.
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्रविड़ उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्छल जलधि तरंगा तब शुभ नामे जागे तब शुभ आशीष मागे गाहे तब जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विदाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
थैंक यू वेरी मच मुनिश्री मंगल पाठ सुनाएंगे मुनिश्री मंगल पाठ
चत्तारि मंगलम अरहंता मंगलम सिद्धा मंगलम साहु मंगलम केवली पन्नतो दम्मो मंगलम चत्तारि लघुत्तमा अरहंता लघुत्तमा सिद्धा लघुत्तमा साहु लघुत्तमा केवली पन्नतो दम्मो लघुत्तमो चत्तारि शरणं भवज्जामि अरहंते शरणं भवज्जामि सिद्धे शरणं भवज्जामि साहु शरणं भवज्जामि केवली पन्नतम धम्मं शरणं भवज्जामि
ओम अरहम